So hi everyone, and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIV Current Affairs. In today's session, guys, we are going to discuss some more important questions from the PIB news, which are relevant for all the government exams. All right, and let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session and you can also ask your doubts, and iska link you can find in the description. All right, and you can also follow me on Instagram. This is my Instagram ID. Here also you can ask any of your queries. So let's talk about the very first question, which says, which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to the National Beekeeping and Honey Mission? So why are we discussing about this National Beekeeping and Honey Mission? Is it a new mission? No, we are discussing about this because recently National Bee Board, which is the nodal agency to implement this particular mission, in collaboration with NAFED, TRIFED and National Dairy Development Board, has organized a national conference on beekeeping. Ek national conference organized hua hai on beekeeping. It was organized by National Bee Board in collaboration with three agencies, which are NAFED, TRIFED and National Dairy Development Board. And the objective of this conference was to strengthen the National Beekeeping and Honey Mission. जो हमारा National Beekeeping and Honey Mission है, उसको strengthen करना is the objective of this particular national conference. Now talking about the National Beekeeping and Honey Mission, guys, so remember it was launched in the year 2020 for a period of 3 years, that is up to the financial year 2023. It was launched with an objective of holistic growth of for beekeeping sector for income and employment generation. इसका basically जो objective है वो क्या है, जो हमारा beekeeping sector है उसका holistic growth. Of course, the ministry is the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, which is headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar, and the implementing agency, the nodal agency for implementation, as I already told you, is National Bee Board. Total fund allocation for this particular scheme, guys, is 500 crore for a period of 3 years. And remember, it is a central sector scheme, which means 100% funding is provided by the central government. इसमें states का कोई भी contribution नहीं है. It is 100% funded by the government of India. Okay. So now let's come back to the question. Then you have to identify the incorrect statement with respect to National Beekeeping and Honey Mission. So the mission was launched in 2020. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Nodal agency to implement the mission is National Bee Board. Yes, ये भी सही है. It is a centrally sponsored scheme. No, it is not a centrally sponsored scheme, guys. It is a central sector scheme, which means option C will be the correct answer. And rupees 500 has been allocated. Sorry, 500 crores hona chahiye tha yahan pe. 500 crore has been allocated for a period of 3 years. So ye bhi bilkul sahi hai, which means option C hamara sahi jawab hai. So let's talk about the question number 2 then. Very, very important question. You are preparing for any exam. Kisi bhi exam ke liye agar aap prepare kar rahe ho, then definitely a question will come from this particular news, which is Corruption Perception Index. So you have to consider the following statements with respect to Corruption Perception Index, and you have to identify the correct statement. So Corruption Perception Index 2021 has been released, and it is every year released by Transparency International, which is headquartered in Berlin. Berlin mein iska headquarter hai, and har saal Corruption Perception Index nikalti hai Transparency International. Remember, this index ranks countries and territories by their perceived level of corruption in the public sector. Public sector corruption ko basically yahan pe map kiya jata hai countries ki. The total number of countries in this year's index is 180. And what is the scale of score, by the way? It is 0 to 100. 0 ka matlab hoga highly corrupt. If you have a 0 score, then you are a highly corrupt country. But if you have a 100 score, then you are a very less corrupt country. Okay? So 0 ka matlab hai kharab score, aur 100 ka matlab hai achha score. Alright? Now let's talk about the rankings. Agar hum rankings ki baat karein, so Denmark, Finland and New Zealand are at the top of the ranking with a score of 88. In teenon ka score kitna hai? 88. Alright, all the three countries have score 88 and all the three are at the top. South Sudan is at the bottom of the ranking with score just 11. Sirf 11 hai. Talking about our pyara Bharat, India ki agar hum baat karein, so India's rank is 85 with a score of 40. And last year ke comparison mein, as compared to the last year, we have jumped one rank. ठीक है, last year हमारा ranking था 86, now we are at 85th position with a score of 40. Norway, Singapore and Sweden are ranked at second position with a विद स्कोर ऑफ 85, तीनों का स्कोर 85 है. स्विट्जरलैंड इज एट रैंक 3 विद अ स्कोर ऑफ 84, नीदरलैंड्स 4th रैंक स्कोर 82 एंड लग्जमबर्ग इज एट रैंक 5th विद अ स्कोर ऑफ 81. नाउ यू मस्ट बी वंडरिंग कि भाई हम आप इतने सारे क्यों बता रहे हो, पांच रैंकिंग तक क्यों बता रहे हो, टॉप बॉटम और इंडिया का क्यों नहीं बता रहे. तो गाइज इसलिए बिकॉज दीज डेज कि क्या हो गया है कि एग्जामिनर्स आर आस्किंग एनीथिंग. इनफैक्ट अभी जो IBPS PO का मेंस हुआ था उसमें आई एम फॉरगेटिंग द नेम ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर इंडेक्स, आई थिंक हेल्दी स्टेट प्रोग्रेसिव इंडिया से वो क्वेश्चन था, तो उसमें 5th नंबर का स्टेट पूछा हुआ था. सो दे आर आस्किंग एनीथिंग. सो ऑफकोर्स हम सारी रैंकिंग्स तो नहीं याद कर सकते, बट नाउ अ डेज देर इज अ नेसेसरी नाउ दैट वी हैव टू लर्न अप टू द फिफ्थ रैंक. ठीक है, अब हमें 5 रैंक तक के जितने कोई भी इंडेक्स है उसको हमें याद करना ही पड़ेगा. ठीक है, दिस इज द नीड ऑफ द आवर नाउ. नाउ अब देखो हम इंडियंस हैं, हमारे दाल में नमक कम हो उससे हमें फर्क नहीं पड़ता, बट हमें नेबर्स जो है हमारे जो पड़ोसी है उसकी दाल में कितना नमक है वो पता होना चाहिए. सो पाकिस्तान की अगर हम बात करें, सो इट इज हैविंग स्कोर 28 एंड इसका रैंक है 160, बहुत ही ज्यादा पुअर है. नेपाल 33, श्रीलंका 37, चाइना 45, द ओनली कंट्री अलॉन्ग विद भूटान, सॉरी नॉट ओनली, भूटान और चाइना दोनों का स्कोर हमसे ज्यादा है. भूटान का तो बहुत ही अच्छा है, 68 है. एंड बांग्लादेश इज एट विद बांग्लादेश हैज द स्कोर 26. ओके, सो दीज आर दी स्कोर्स ऑफ द नेबरिंग कंट्रीज, ये भी हमें पता होना चाहिए. नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट अदर की पॉइंट्स फ्रॉम दिस पर्टिकुलर इंडेक्स, सो एवरेज ग्लोबल स्कोर गाइज इन दिस अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस पर्टिकुलर इंडेक्स इज 43. मोर देन 2/3 ऑफ द कंट्रीज, दैट इज 60% ऑफ द कंट्रीज अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड स्कोर्ड बिलो 50. मोर देन 2/3 कंट्रीज में 50 से कम स्कोर है, तो आप देख सकते हैं कि करप्शन का लेवल कितना हाई है. हाईएस्ट स्कोरिंग रीजन की अगर बात करें, सो दैट इज वेस्टर्न यूरोप एंड यूरोपियन यूनियन विद अ स्कोर ऑफ 66/100. लोएस्ट स्कोरिंग रीजन इज द सब सहारन अफ्रीका विद अ स्कोर ऑफ जस्ट 33/100. एन एवरेज स्कोर ऑफ एशिया पैसिफिक रीजन गाइज इज 45. ओके, सो दैट्स इट, इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज्यादा देयर इज नो नीड. सो नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन, देन यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. सो इंडिया हैज बीन रैंक्ड एट 85 विद अ स्कोर ऑफ 40, दैट्स एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. एवरेज ग्लोबल स्कोर ऑफ CPI इज नॉट 53, इट इज 43. डेनमार्क, फिनलैंड एंड नॉर्वे आर एट द टॉप विद अ स्कोर ऑफ 88. नॉर्वे नहीं है, सो दिस इज इनकरेक्ट. द इंडेक्स हैज रैंक्ड 180 कंट्रीज, सो दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. सो 1 and 4 गाइस शुड बी द करेक्ट आंसर. सो ऑप्शन सी, ओनली 1 and 4 विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. आई होप गाइस दिस क्वेश्चन इज क्लियर. एंड नाउ लेट्स कम टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. Which of the following departments of Government of India will collaborate with governments of Jammu and Kashmir, Government of Jammu and Kashmir for 3 major good governance initiatives in Jammu and Kashmir? Jammu and Kashmir में 3 major good governance initiative के लिए कौन सा department भारत सरकार का जम्मू कश्मीर के साथ collaboration करेगा? That is the question. So remember the department is Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances. So the correct answer is option B. But we have to we should know about the 3 projects. So number 1 is creation of an online portal for monitoring progress in 58 district good governance index indicators, which was recently launched by Jammu and Kashmir administration. Adoption of EHRMS, human resource management system, in the Jammu secretariat and Srinagar secretariat. And number 3, monitoring online the citizen satisfaction in 150 e-services provided through Jammu and Kashmir e-services delivery assessment framework. ठीक है जी, so these are the 3 projects for which the Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances has collaborated with the Government of Jammu and Kashmir, and that's why the correct answer is what? Option B. Now let's talk about question number 4, very very important question again. Which of the following CPSEs, Central Public Sector Enterprises, has scored a perfect score of 100 as per the targets and milestones set up by the Department of Public Enterprises under the Ministry of Finance under an MOU framework for all the CPSEs? So do remember that this department lies under the umbrella of Ministry of Finance. All right, so this is REC Limited guys has scored a perfect score of 100 for financial year 2021. Now ab ye jo score hai ye kahan se aaya, kyun aaya? So this score is as per the targets and milestones set up by the Department of Public Enterprises. Remember, all the central public enterprises, all the CPSEs are evaluated on the basis of an एमओयू फ्रेमवर्क प्रिस्क्राइब फॉर ऑल द सीपीएसईज. बेसिकली इस एमओयू में उनको बताया गया था कि व्हाट आर द टारगेट्स, व्हाट शुड बी द माइलस्टोन्स दैट यू हैव टू अचीव इन अ पर्टिकुलर फाइनेंशियल ईयर. एंड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर फ्रेमवर्क आरईसी लिमिटेड हैज स्कोर्ड अ परफेक्ट स्कोर. एंड रिमेंबर आरईसी लिमिटेड इज द ओनली सीपीएसई अमंग द 123 सीपीएसईज अक्रॉस 32 सेक्टर्स व्हिच हैज स्कोर्ड दिस परफेक्ट स्कोर ऑफ 100. टॉकिंग अबाउट आरईसी लिमिटेड, सो रिमेंबर इट इज अ नवरत्न कंपनी. It is a Navratna company under the Ministry of Power headed by Mr. R.K. Singh. And the objective, what it does, ye iska kaam kya hai? It finances and promotes the power projects of the country. Finance karna aur promote karna the power projects in the country is the objective of REC. Alright. So therefore, guys, the correct answer will be what? Option D, REC Limited is the correct answer. And now let's talk about the question number 5, which is the last question for today. With which of the following countries Government of India has signed an MOU for cooperation in health research, specifically in the area of emerging infectious diseases. Alright, so remember in this particular question, we do not have to go into the details. Just remember the Government of India has signed this MOU for cooperation in health research, specifically in the area of emerging infectious diseases with France. Option A, France is the correct answer. And from India side, CSIR's Council of Scientific and Industrial Research has signed this MOU. Okay, so option A is the correct answer. So that's it for the session, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.